To win Mary's heart, Remington revealed the truth of his origin. Turns out, Remington was a poor nobleman who signed a pact with the infernal Davy Jones. For the price of his soul, Davy made Remington immortal. The all-powerful Remington joined forces with Caribbean pirates and acquired a formidable crew. And now, thanks to Mary, the captain promised to end his pirate career. The star-crossed lovers planned to marry at once, with all the seas pirates in attendance to witness their vows to each other. On the eve of the wedding, a military coalition struck the fortress full of defenseless pirates. The Caribbean Sea turned red with blood, and Skull Island became a place of torment. Remington was sentenced to death before Mary's eyes. The young countess was broken-hearted.
Remington's mad. I couldn't stop him as he took my remains from my grave. He's planning to bring me back, but we'll never recover the time we lost. The doors to the underground bay are sealed with a pattern. I wore this pattern all my life.
Thank you. have to admit, you don't give up easily. I'm this close to bringing my love back to life, and I don't have time to bother with you right now. You dare to say she wouldn't want to be resurrected? That's nonsense. It's the only way we can be together after all these years. If you think you're so smart, bring me proof that my beloved doesn't want to return. You would have to summon her ghost, you fool. I won't believe you until you let me talk to my beloved.
Now I'm whole again. Love is eternal, but people are so fragile. I need to talk with Henry before he makes a mistake. Take me to my captain.
Someone has taken the body.
Baron Bannister was claimed victorious for killing Remington and his nefarious crew. The Baron capitalized on his success by forcing his daughter to marry the Captain of the Royal Navy. Mary endured a childless and unhappy marriage with the old dull soldier. And when her spouse eventually died, Mary, now a wealthy widow, decided to return to Skull Island. Even though Skull Island was now a sad and dreary place, memories of happier times came back to Mary as she started wandering the familiar grounds. Mary used the money she inherited to build a crypt for her and her captain if his body was ever found. Soon after that, the lonely Mary died. According to her wishes, she was buried at the new crypt.
I won't believe you until you let me talk to my beloved.
I do not wish to be resurrected, my love. It's time you joined me.
Stay, please. I was so blind and selfish. After all this time, she still only wants that I give up on this cruel and vengeful life. She wanted an ordinary man, not a legendary criminal. Rather than resurrecting her, I should join her in the afterlife. Perhaps she is waiting for me there. Find those 12 cursed doubloons and bring me my deposit, the only thing that can make me a mortal man again.
Meanwhile, as the centuries passed, the immortal Captain Remington lay at the bottom of the sea. Brokenhearted, stripped of his enchanted weapons, and weighted down by shackles and corals. The only person who could make him happy was dead. The only thing which could redeem him, a gift for the bride, was still in the cursed chest on his galleon. Remington grew weaker and weaker under the sea, waiting for a chance to set things right. You brought the doubloons, but have you found the pearl?
Are you all right? Mom! You saved me!
I always will.